Here we go, baby.
The right side of these lines coming at you, the inside line. Denny Hamlin on the outside. They make up row number one. As we are getting ready for the start.
Chase Elliott.
The Brickyard 400.
Third.
Motor Speedway.
Here we go.
The draft will be important. We see some getting out of line, some getting in line. William Byron under attack in the 24.
When we talk about, you can see some guys just thinking they have to run the bottom of the racetrack, others trying to make that second lane work. Christopher Valiant learns that when the tires are done, the jack drops, the car leaves. You don't have to wait on gas. If you ran longer, you would have longer pit stops, Marty, because the fuel required to fill your car up.
It seems so much pressure on these pit crews under these green flag stops to not lose any track time for their drivers. Chase Elliott said his car fired off a little bit tighter than he thought it would, but it was so good the longer he ran. They're going to get four fresh Goodyear tires and fuel to make it to the end of here, stage one. Meanwhile, Kyle Larson here back on the oval after running the 8500 in the month of May. Your tires.
Marty Mitchell running the five run of the 8500. Qualified fifth for the 8500, qualified fifth for this race. You see the 11 who had been to pit road is going to get back out in front of these cars.
I think the key to the 11 car here is that he got in clean air. When he came out on the racetrack, look, there's only one car in front of him, Martin Truex Jr., and he's way out in front of him. So he was able to get out, no car. Make two laps, new tires, clean air, and those were the fastest laps he could make.
And that's not luck. That's part of the plan. Chris Gabehart, both of these teams have a predictor model to tell you where they'll rejoin the pack. Jeff, to your point, that's as important as anything, right? We've seen guys, when they break traffic, they'll pick up a half a second. Just having a little bit of a clean in front. There's Chris Gabehart at the bottom, looking on board.
This play into Tyler Reddick's hand and their strategy. Do they have to come to pit road here quickly?
I don't know if they have to. Leading the race is running pretty good lap times overall. William Byron's, we're going to see. I mean, this is basically what it looks like. Byron's a lap down to the 45 currently. We'll see if these new tires work for the 20 cam. So he was way behind the field. Here he's not.
Chase Elliott on the pass.
He's not yelling. He needs to understand because the verbiage of how it reads is you have to use the access lane before you can enter the track. Now, I think the 9 has done what we have seen in years past. NASCAR obviously not agree. Marty.
And Chase Elliott's hot, as you can imagine, Steve. He said, I studied the sheet they sent to me yesterday. I did exactly what they told me I could do. So they told him right now to stay below the white line on the outside right there. Chase Bowler, Trey Bowler, his father should stay below that line. Chase Elliott did it that time. But Chase again saying, I did exactly what NASCAR said I could do.
Actually asked this question this morning because we've seen multiple times how this happens, and NASCAR felt they had communicated with the drivers to tell them what the rule would be. Let's listen to Chase Elliott.
Hey, what the? They sent out the sheet yesterday, did exactly what they told us to do.
So NASCAR is saying that all four have to be below the second white line. Cannot access the racetrack.
Well, the verbiage of the sheet he's referring to is the handout, and the exact term is you must use the access road until the exit of turn two. That's what's printed on the sheet. So NASCAR feels when he goes driver's right of the second white line, he's no longer on the access road. That would be how they officiate this situation.
Is on pit road. Kim.
And he's going to make a stop right in his box. Kozlowski's saying it's going to be here, but it's struggling in dirty air. They like
in the stage. And race leader Denny Hamlin has a 2.6 second or 2/10 of a second lead over Kyle Larson, running second right now, just in front of Wade.
And this is going to be very controversial. NASCAR sent me the latest email they sent to drop the teams, and it says stay off the racing surface. And you can swing wide beyond the white line on the acceleration lanes between one and two, but stay off the racing surface.
So there, the six has just got its right side tires on what we would call the racing surface, not the racing line, but the surface.
I don't know if I would call that the racing surface. That's the problem with that update.
But isn't that white line that signifies the apron of a racetrack?
Yeah, but it hasn't for 14 years that we've run the Brickyard 400. I've seen drivers go out there all the time. So, you know, to Jeff's point about controversy, I mean, now we see some...